Hi, welcome to Numerix Video Blog. I'm your host, Jim Jockel. Joining me today is Alex Marion, VP of Product Management here at Numerix for Insurance Products. Alex, how are you?
I'm great.
Alex, last time we talked about trends in insurance companies and elements of onboarding new technologies. And, you know, kind of bucking the trend of what we're seeing more on the banking side and the capital market side, where we're starting to see a lot more outsourcing and investment in insurance, we're seeing insourcing. Mm-hmm. And one of the areas in particular is around economic scenario generation.
Sure. And,
perhaps, first of all, could you give us a good definition of economic scenario generation? And then let's talk about some of the trends of why insurance companies are starting to inboard new technologies.
Sure. Well, there's two dominant use cases of economic scenario generation technology in insurance companies. The first one is risk-neutral ESGs, which are risk-neutral models, which are models used for pricing and hedging embedded derivatives in insurance products such as variable annuities or fixed index annuities. So risk-neutral dynamics are the absolute correct dynamics to use for valuing these embedded derivatives, just like they would at banks. The other use case is what they call real-world or realistic scenario generation, and under these have been around for a while in insurance companies, and companies are now using a stochastic set of real-world scenarios to project forward their liabilities for capital and reserving requirements. And they're looking to do that on an enterprise-wide platform. So for things like AG 43 calculations or risk-based capital or economic capital applications, they're all using these real-world ESG solutions to project forward their balance sheet across different lines of business.
So we've also, in the annuity space, seen a lot of moving around in terms mm-hmm. of people entering the business, people exiting the business, buying different books of business. You know, what is kind of a best practice as it relates to, you know, building these books and, you know, driven through, you know, for lack of a better term, acquisition?
Sure. So there has been a lot of M&A activity in the insurance space. A lot of it has been about rebuilding capital positions and trying to decide how do we effectively deploy capital. So when risk managers and insurance executives are looking at the opportunities in the market, they have to have the tools that help them turn data into data information into management decisions. What lines of business will I best deploy my capital to? What other lines of business should I be de-risking? Are they consuming capital? And to do that, they really need a consistent enterprise risk management framework across different products and different lines of business. And economic scenario generators allow them to sort of unify these different legacy cash flow systems and different valuation systems in a single consistent framework.
So you mentioned stochastic issues, which brings its own host of challenges.
Sure.
In terms of deploying different hybrid models and moving away from more traditional mm-hmm. Black and things of that nature. Tell me a little bit more about the onboardings of this type of technology and how equipped are these companies to maneuver more complex models?
Sure. So if you look at the variable annuity market or the fixed index market where these annuities have these embedded derivatives, a lot of companies are bringing in their hedge programs in-house, right? So they're dynamically hedging the embedded derivative risk, whether it's guaranteed minimum withdrawal benefits, other VA guarantees, or some of the fixed index annuity crediting strategies. When they do reserve calculations or hedge strategy projection on some of these businesses, they have to project forward that hedging strategy. And to do that, they have to have an outer loop of realistic scenarios to project forward the business, but they have to revalue those hedges and the liabilities at each inner loop node along those real-world paths. So that's the general framework of the nested stochastic problem, and it can be very computationally intense. Now, if you have a consistent modeling dynamic between your risk-neutral models and your real-world models, you can build out a nested stochastic framework that's consistent, it's defensible, and it's optimized for computational runtime. And using, a lot of companies now are looking to use cloud computing solutions to enhance their nested stochastic capabilities by overcoming some of the runtime issues.
And that's more from an infrastructure as a service,
sure.
A burst type cloud.
Right, exactly.
So one of the questions, as a driver, also the hedging programs themselves and the strategies being employed are becoming much more sophisticated.
Sure. A lot of, for example, in the variable annuity market, a lot of companies have been trying to move the hedging from the insurer back to the policyholder in the form of these risk-managed funds, whether they're managed vol strategies or capital protection overlays, they're sort of farming out some of that risk, whether it's vega risk. They're moving it into the funds, where the funds are sort of de-risking as market goes down, as volatility increases, and that translates to a lower Greek profile for some of the embedded guarantees and a lower hedging cost. So as part of the de-risking theme in the variable annuity market, this has been probably the central component of that, is to sort of move some of the guarantee derivative risk back, you know, over to the policyholder in the form of these managed products.
Well, Alex, I want to thank you so much for your time today. And of course, we want to talk about the topics that you want to talk about. So if you're on Twitter, please add us at NX Analytics, or on LinkedIn to stay up to date for all of the conversations that we have, whether it's our webinar programs, our events, and updates on our video blog. So with that, I'm going to say thank you again, Alex.
Thank you.
And we'll see you next time.